Ladies and gentlemen, in the previous video, we showed and explained four layouts of microgrids. The question often asked is, what is the best architecture and layout with respect to the overall efficiency? The main learning objectives will fall under two main questions. First, what is and what are the most efficient layouts? And second, how could the efficiency of components affect the choice of layout? Let's now compare the efficiency of the previous four layouts. A is the layout with the AC coupled configuration. B is the DC coupled hybrid configuration with the main inverter to the AC bus. C is a centralized DC coupled configuration, and D is the mixed coupled architecture. A comparison can be made between the four types of microgrid listed above. Let's see the PV solar power aspect first. This can be shown in the graph that the AC microgrid has a higher efficiency only if more than 85% of the PV solar energy is directly consumed by the load. Or we have to store the solar power because of the mismatch between the generated solar power and the loads, because the efficiency is higher in the DC microgrid or hybrid coupled microgrid. Scenarios B, C and D have 10.8% higher efficiency than scenario A, when all the photovoltaic array power is used from the battery storage. Let's now have a look for the case when all the diesel generated power is directly used. We can see in the graph that all scenarios except scenario C give the same and higher efficiency of maximum 9.8% higher. This can be also seen by simply looking and counting the converter losses at the configurations. When all the diesel generator power is stored in the battery and used later, the topologies with scenarios B, C and D always have the same and better efficiency, maximum 4.8% higher, than the centralized AC coupled topology of scenario A. For any diesel generator power used between the maximum directly and maximum via the battery use, scenarios B and D always have the same and higher efficiency than the other scenarios. Let us have a look at the wind power use in different microgrid topologies and scenarios. We notice in the graph that scenario A and D have the same and higher efficiency of consumption than the other scenarios. Thus, in the windy areas and for a direct use of wind power, either centralized AC coupled scenario, it means scenario A, or mixed coupled scenario, it means scenario D, is preferred, and a maximum of 9.8% higher efficiency can be gained over the others. If all the power from the wind generator is used after it had been stored in the battery bank first, all topologies except scenario A give the same and higher efficiency, which is a maximum of 4.8% higher. Considering the total power consumption from the wind generator, partly directly used and partly via the battery, it can be seen from figure on the slide that scenario D, which is a mixed coupling of sources, always give higher efficiency than the other scenarios, and thus mixed coupling topology is the best choice when only the wind power is taken into account. One possible improvement is to move the wind generator from AC bus to the middle of the AC and DC bus. Nonetheless, there are endless different variations of the connection topologies that can be adopted to increase the efficiency, reducing the converter losses, like placing wind turbine from the AC bus in the middle of the AC and DC buses. In this video, we compared the performance of four layouts with respect to their efficiency. The conclusion is that there is no best choice of microgrid layout for all the operating conditions. Depending on the type and size of the components in the microgrids, as well as the mismatch between generation and loads, one microgrid layout might be preferred over another one.